My name is Martin Vetterli. I'm the president of École Polytechnique Fédérale de Lausanne, EPFL, in Lausanne, Switzerland. The Center for Digital Trust at EPFL was created in order to answer the challenges posed by digitalization of society and the lack of trust in digital services. This is a question that is very interdisciplinary because the notion of trust is fundamental to advanced societies. In the analog world, we know exactly what trust is. It's a handshake, it's recognizing a face, it's signing a physical contract. In the digital world, many of these concepts have yet to be, if not invented, at least to be deployed so that people actually use them. And it has many questions that have ethical components, governance components, legal and societal questions. And that's the aim of the Center for Digital Trust, to bring all these partners around the table on such questions. The first item is, of course, privacy. And we have a very good sense of privacy in the analog, in the physical world, but we don't have the sense of privacy in the digital world because it's much fuzzier, it's non-transparent, and it's something totally new. The second one is security of data. Is our conversation encrypted or is it not? Is it listened to by third parties, etc.? The third one is discrimination or implicit bias. Okay, so many of the machine learning algorithms use a lot of data that was collected, and of course these data collections might have implicit biases in them of various sorts. So the question of regulation in the digital world is of course fundamental. And I think it is time that society takes back the control of these issues. In itself, digital technologies need to be much more sustainable. If you think about sustainability, it has a lot to do with monitoring if things are sustainable or not. So this is certification of products, monitoring, for example, of reserves, of forests, and so on. Our experience at EPFL during the confinement, during the COVID-19 time, is that you cannot move education purely digital. The education at EPFL will continue by being hybrid, and to have a hybrid or blended education where you take the best from both worlds, from the digital world and from the analog world. Technologies for 2021, the whole question of developing vaccines at scale and distributing vaccines and following up, measuring what happens following the pandemic, etc., will be the number one challenge for 2021. Number two, I think the successes of artificial intelligence and machine learning to solve deep scientific questions will continue to deliver incredible results. The third one, which is probably the biggest challenge, is that 2021 has to deliver technologies to fight climate change. The biggest pandemic we face is climate change. And if we don't now provide technologies and make them economically viable, we are going to be in hot water not too long from now.